Hey, what's up, guys? I'm very camera shy, but I thought I'd give it a try, and probably it's a good thing. But more importantly, I want to talk about an issue which was pointed out to me today in a comment, which I was not aware, and I want to go through and see and how we can fix it. I make myself a bit smaller here. Now this is more important. So we'll talk about this data map. This data map here. So maybe this site is better. So we will talk about this weather data map. So this is the E plus weather data map provided by Ladybug tools. And all these points are links to a different weather data files, which come from different servers, I guess. So the problem was actually pointed out by Asma Almohanadi. I hope that's correct. It puzzled me because I never had that issue before, but it's by the way, thanks for all the questions you're sending me, and that's actually what I hoped happens, that people engage and we all learn together. So Asma Almohanadi is saying, "Hi Philip, I tried to copy the URL link of the E plus weather map and connect it to the Ladybug download weather component, which I will show you later. But the link I get from the E plus weather maps website is a zip file containing the E plus weather file. I tried connecting the downloaded E plus weather file to a file path and link it to the folder input in the Ladybug download weather component, but it turns red and the note says input parameter weather URL failed to collect data. So I thought first, yeah, probably the link was not pasted correctly, or there was maybe something wrong connected in the script. But it turns out that is actually not the problem of the script, it's the problem of the weather map. Or better, the links, because it turns out some of the links are actually not active. That's a short answer, but we will check actually a bit more in depth on how we could find out if a weather data set doesn't work and why it doesn't work. So for that reason, we just go into Ladybug, and by the way, so I will show the procedure on how you actually get the weather data. So for anybody who is new to the software, they can also watch this tutorial and they will learn how to actually import the weather data into the script. So first we need three components. We need the Ladybug download weather component. This is this one. That's what Asma was talking about, that it didn't load the weather data. We need this tool here, which is actually the link to the weather map, the weather data map. For this, we need to toggle here. And then we need this tool here. This is the main weather file import tool, and which make all the data available to use for you later in the script. So then we need some panels. Copy this, copy that. I love to use panels because it tells you immediately what's inside a component. And this we will need to place our weather file URL. So first we just click on the toggle, which brings us to the weather file, and I will choose a weather data set which I know it works. Go here, and I always use the copy link to clipboard. I will tell you why I use that. So I download this, I just click here, then nothing happens, but it's saved in the clipboard, and then I can just paste it in here. So this one actually is not, it doesn't show as a zip file. So just to clarify, it doesn't matter if the link points to a folder or a folder with the data or a zip file. That doesn't matter. So I create another panel here just to for you to better understand. I found another weather data file which is actually a zip file. So when I click here on copy link to clipboard and I place this into my panel, then you can see it's a zip file. So let's go here. So this is actually pointing to a folder with all, means all data, I guess. But I know here that this is a zip file. Either way, I can connect this here. When this turns gray, I know it worked. So it actually successfully connected the URL with the script, and I can actually read out the data. For example, here I can read the location or the dry pulp temperature. It doesn't show you the temperature here because there are too many values, but well, okay, I still need that. So I will do the same for this file from Cyprus, and this is the zip. This is the zip file. And yeah, it also works. So I can go here back and you can see the location, and it successfully created the link, because actually in both cases what it doesn't do anything else than download the weather data and place it in a folder on your computer. So for better understanding, this second slot here is if you want to use an alternative folder, then you can use that. So for example, if you don't want to use this folder here, you can use a folder like this. I have a folder here in the C drive, which is called Ladybug. And I could actually do this. Copy this here. I think it need to have a backslash at the end. But if I now put this in here, it actually copies the weather data into this folder. So you can see it works fine. So again, so this is, I just placed the URL in here, I connect it here, and here I can add an optional folder if I want, and it place the weather data into here. And then it just reads out the data into the weather file. So in Asma's case, it seemed none of these options worked, and I tried to understand what happened. So, and realized that some of these weather data links, they don't work. So for example, I go here and I click here, and now I place my link into here. It tells me it turns red. What should we do? What should we do when this turns red? This is the question. Okay, so you can see here actually there's no data was collected. That's, first of all, that's interesting. So it didn't actually download anything. And by the way, in the legacy tools, if you use the legacy tools and you add and you do this, you enter, then this link doesn't work. In the new Ladybug file tools, it doesn't matter. You can have both. But yeah, you can see actually it did not even collect anything. Now, what happened? So I realized that if you go here and if you download, and it actually shows you the link, but when you click here, it goes to a URL which was not found. The requested URL was not found on the server. It means even though I would download this, save link as, I can even save the zip file here. So I have now the zip file, but as you can see, it has only 1 kilobyte. Now if I could try to open that, gives you an error because there's actually nothing inside. So Asma, that's probably the issue. So I'm very sorry for that. This is something should be pointed out to the Ladybug developers. What could be though is that it's just temporary and this is a server issue and the server is just not working. But it's interesting that, I mean, I'm 100% sure that you did not use this one. You use for sure another weather set. It would be quite interesting if you chose exactly the same weather set as me. Well, let's try another one. Let's see here. Yes. So here, it seems like there are. That worked. This worked. So it seems that some of these data sets are not either up to date, either the server doesn't work. Here again. So this is something really that would be good to point out to the Ladybug tools developers to see what the issue is. Let's try something else here. Let's see here. That worked. Yeah, that didn't work. So some of these files are not, either maybe they're outdated or maybe the link is not correct anymore. Would be, yeah, it's quite a shame if that would be something permanent. Yeah, it's quite a lot of these links don't work. So I will definitely raise that to the developers. Asma, sorry. I guess that's the only way for you is to try to find the closest weather set which works. So as I just did here, I go on the link and I click on download and see if there's actually anything in that link. Hope it makes sense. Could be that a lot of other people have the same issue, and if so, yeah, it's not cool. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next time.